Hi and welcome everybody. Welcome to a new episode of Fresh Jazzy Sounds. I have another batch of great vinyl released in this year or 2020. We start off with Five Sonics. They're an LA jazz band. They released an album. I think they did it privately. It's called The Cradle. Five Sonics consists of four people. So you have tenor sax, flute is done by Sylvain Carton. Wurlitzer is played by Mitchell Yoshida. Drums by Josh Colasano, all unfamiliar names to me. And the acoustic bass is by Seth Fort John, and he is also the founder of the band. And it has this, I call out the names as they are four people because it sounds like a trio. It has that vibe of a small trio playing this kind of jazz with a little bit of grooviness to that. It sounds beautiful. If you can grab this album, I would suggest to at least listen to it and see if you like it, because it has some beautiful music on it. And surprisingly, for the next album, we stay in LA. Another new band, or a new band to me, released an album which is, it feels a little bit like those early 70s albums like Andy Hay, that there's this special vibe going on.
There lived a great people.
It's called Pathways and Passages, Cosmic Vibration, featuring Dwight Tribal. And that is the guy who you hear now speaking.
And our overwhelming responsibility.
It gives this music its really unique character. And you like it or you dislike it. I don't think there's an in-between. I don't know what the hype stickers. It says a new LA-based ensemble led by Dwight Tribal that defines spiritual jazz in the 21st century. That's a little bit of probably too much, but it shows a little bit the direction they wanted to take with this album. Music really shows that a lot of new jazz is being made, and this is made to be also counterbalancing all the UK jazz, or that really staying in the front light. And if you say UK jazz, everybody knows what you're talking about, but when you're talking like the last two bands, LA based jazz bands, not so many people know it, and they're making great music. And there's another country that is really, I don't know if it is a one-time happening or that it will be something that is continuously growing there. But like UK jazz, in Europe there's another country which has its own kind of jazz. I don't want to say it immediately, but it was more electronic based or electronic influences. It really went its own direction, and I'm really curious what is going to happen in the future. What I'm talking about is Caraba. I think that's the way you pronounce it. It is from Berlin and it is released on the label Crytox, I think that's the way you pronounce it. They have different artists going into different directions. So you have them going to the more new classical, more electronic bass, like you have Niels Fram a little bit in that direction. You have them going into a direction of they call it crowd jazz. And it seems to be a right description because it's really mixing those cosmic sounds, but with the beautiful crowd jazz that you had halfway 70s, not the early 70s, which was more rock based, but that halfway 70s vibe, and you can hear it on this one. And I really hope that this is something new, which will blossom in the future. The next track I want to play, and I have to play it, is Space Funk. Sounds great, right? As I already mentioned, the UK, we are now moving to the UK. Cleo Salt. For people who have been listening to Salt, they probably recognize the name or know the name. It is Salt, there's a lot of mystery. This album by Cleo Salt is a little bit the same. It does not mention that much, although it gives a little bit more information of what you're hearing. Sleepless nights, the deepest cries. And I must say, I have to thank Mark. He named this the album of 2020, the best album of 2020. Probably there's a little bit of nostalgia going on, but there is also something fresh. And I have to agree with Mark that this is almost better as Salt. And that mainly has to do, it is very natural, it is very flowing, it just fits 100%. Her voice and the music, it is really, really nice. Although there is also something very recognizable, that's why I called it nostalgia, because there's something beginning of the 2000s, and I can't put my finger on it, but there's this same vibe going on, especially in her voice on this song. It's so attractive, and it's really hard to stop the needle drop because I really like this album. The next one is an 45. Or an EP by Sammy. I don't know that much about her, Let me put it the right way. No, it doesn't fit anymore. Let me remember to change the RPMs. And as you can hear, not so much jazzy, much more soul based. On the other hand, why did I pick it up? What was the attraction, or what triggered me to get this one? And that's mainly to do with the production. I think this is the debut of Sammy, but all the songs are produced by Dago and by Kaji Taram. Is it that the way you pronounce it? He does a lot of plays a lot of the electric keys on a lot of albums. He has his own albums, but he cooperates with a lot of people, like on this one. And his playing is very recognizable. It's almost 70s Herbie Hancock jazz funk. He really has that in his fingers. And it is fun to pick up these albums. Let me first put it back on 33. For the next, we stay in the UK, kind of. We mix it with a little bit of Italian. And I must say, this is a special album. This is like the first one I showed. This one is really a jazz trio. The first one by Sonics was four people. But this is an album in a similar vibe. So if you like the first album, I'm pretty sure you're going to like this one. It is by Mark de Clive Lowe. He is, I think during touring, he is joined by Andrea Lombardini and Tommaso Cappellato. Italian names there. You can put them in Formula One and they have the right name already. They sound fast. But they, Andrea and Tommaso, inspired Mark de Clive Lowe to do it a little bit different, or at least to strip down his music a little. So let me see if I can see who's playing what. Tommaso is doing the drums and percussion, Andrea is doing electric and double bass, and Mark de Clive Lowe is of course playing piano, Fender Rhodes and the synths. By stripping down the music, but not by slowing it down, they created this really perfect blend of groovy music and jazzy music, and it's called Dreamweavers, and it really it inspires you to dream away with this music. Always fun when people are really interplaying and the connection is there, and I think that's because they were touring that they really the interplay is superb on this one. And the next album is quite funny. It is an album that the people who released it, the label, said they would never reissue it ever again when the first time they did it. It's a library album, Freedom Power. It is reissued by Sonar Music Editions, SME. It is actually, the first pressing is 001 from the label. This was the first album they reissued. They've done, I don't know how many library albums in between, all high quality. I don't want to take anything away from Sonam Music, because of them I have found and discovered many library albums I would have not known if it wasn't for them. But it's fun. There was such high request for this one that they reissued it. I think after a week they say it's sold out, as it turns out. I think it's now more than 6 months ago. Copies are still available, but it does not take away. It is a very nice album with some great music on it. And those Italian library albums, like maybe previous albums I showed, if you put in the Italian ingredients, it makes it a little bit funky also. And although they don't try to be funky, it just sounds that way. And I am not familiar with the people who are playing on this album. I don't think the backside gives any hints who are playing. But of course, it's studio musicians. Probably the names on the back are not the real names, although I recognize some. Great music. It really plays as an album. It's very enjoyable. I hope you also enjoyed this episode. Thank you for watching. See you next time.